Hello everyone, I, Harneet Kaur, Assistant Professor, Department of English, Cultural Studies and Foreign Languages, GSS, DGS, Khalsa College, Patiala, will be taking up topic Introduction to Language and its Functions. Let's begin. Language. Language is the ability to acquire and use complex system of communication, particularly by humans. All social animals communicate with each other, from bees and ants to whales. But only humans have developed a language which is more than a set of pre-arranged signals. Edward Speer defines language as follows. Language is a purely human and non-instinctive method of communicating ideas, emotions, and desires by means of voluntarily produced symbols. In other words, language is the ability to learn and use system of complex communication, or to describe the set of rules that make up these systems, or the set of utterances that can be produced from these rules. Noam Chomsky defines language as a language is a set of sentences, each finite in length and constructed out of the finite set of elements. Language is a structured system of communicating with help of spoken or written symbols, specifically arranged by human beings as members of social group to express their feelings, emotions, and exchange ideas. Human language is produced orally and received through the ear. Language can be through speech, written, or by signs. It constantly keeps on evolving. Every language is unique in itself. Every language uses a unique set of different sounds and concepts to convey message. Evolution of language. It must have been a long process. There are about 5,000 to 7,000 languages spoken in the world today, but they are grouped into few families. Languages are linked to each other by shared words or sounds or grammatical constructions. The shared linguistic family does not imply any racial link. Language is thought to have originated when early humans started gradually changing their communication system. Humans acquired language through social interaction in early childhood, and children generally speak fluently at about age of 3. The scientific study of language is called linguistics. It is a science that concerns itself with all aspects of language, examining it from all the theoretical and vocal points of view. Every human culture has some sort of social organization, some sort of system. All these are governed by structuralist analysis. A structure is any system that has property of wholeness. That is, it works as a whole, not as independent parts. Secondly, transformation. That is, system is not static, but capable of change and self-regulation, which implies that new elements can be added, but basic structure system can't be changed. Ferdinand de Saussure, a Swiss linguist, provided structuralist analysis of language. He says that language is based on a naming process by which things get associated with a word or name. Linguistic unit has two parts, concept and sound image. Sound image is the psychological imprint of the sound in our minds. Linguistic sign is the combination of signifier and signified. Sound image is the signifier and the concept is signified. Language attains value only when collective meaning is assigned to signs. It takes community to set up the relation between any particular sound image or any particular concept. Language has many functions in our day-to-day life. Language has personal or emotive function. Through language, the speaker shows his/her emotions from speaker's point of view. And from the listener's point of view, it has directive and instrumental function. It makes listener do something, but also doing something what the speaker wants. Majorly, language has five functions. Informational. This function of language concentrates on the message. It is used to give new information. Expressive. Language has expressive aspect as well. It can be used to express its originator's feelings and attitudes. For example, swear words, exclamation, they all are quintessential of this function. Poetry and literature also come under umbrella of expressive function. Directive. In this speaker aims to influence the behavior and attitude of others. Commands and requests are some of instances of this function. This function places emphasis on the receiver's end as well. Aesthetic. The fourth function is the aesthetic function, which is the use of language for sake of linguistic artifact itself and for no other purpose. All art understood as art is taken to embody this function, and any object valued for its beauty rather than for its ideological value or usefulness. Phatic function. It is the function of keeping communication lines open and keeping social relationship in good repairs. It is used for normal talks. An example of this is when two people meet each other accidentally and start talking. I hope I am able to put some insight on this topic. Thank you so much.